Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Greetings to you all on this Kids' Day. Emat, where scripture is revealed in its simplest format. And the reason that it is vital, because we as a nation, we must, as Torah, as Shaul, instruct those of Corinthians. He said, first of all, you must zara, you must test, you must try the validity of all things by what was written in the beginning. So if you don't prove all things and hold fast to that which is tough. Now, you don't prove it by some kind of intellectual excellence. It must come by the means of Torah, the wisdom of Yah's counsel, the understanding of His Mishrach, a government that rules within the mind of His nation, and that we may do all things or fashion ourselves according to what is written in the book. It cannot come any other way, Yisrael. And so we have this purporting or this promotion of all kinds of opinions. Everyone has a judgment, an opinion of every matter. And yet they do not understand the gravity of Torah. They have no knowledge, no understanding of even what the book says. Because the vast populace of his nation, we certainly do not take delight in this book. And because of that, we are very unhealthy people here. Our minds cannot retain. We don't love him. Although we speak words as though that we truly love him, it's just not the truth, Yisrael. In order for us to understand the very dynamics of this, we must have the ability to listen, to train our minds to hear. As a man trains his body for the excellence, as one trains themselves to master the extreme, to take upon the physical challenges, whereby this must be prepared to take upon any challenge. That's why we tend to fail. We tend to fail at every challenge that is set before us. And it's very sad. It is incumbent upon this nation. And there is the reason why, Yisrael. There is the reason why. As our Zochim Benjamin was praying concerning this time that we're in, this day that has passed, the demonic control, the power has been exuded over the minds of the nation of people. Now, you know, we will look at that and say that, well, I don't do it. And yet we're so guilty of defying Torah. Damn Christmas. Damn every aspect of Christmas. It has been generated from the gates of hell. Damn their lying Jesus Christ. You understand? There are those that get offended at that. I frankly do not give a damn. It makes me no difference at all, their emotional setbacks. I was thinking, my friend, as I picked up this book, you all see that this is a facsimile of the original. You all know what syntax is. It is the grammatics, the formation of grammar to constitute words, to reveal unto us the identity of our Abba. This is a 1611 facsimile King James Bible. I challenge any man, any woman, anywhere, to show me one scintilla of the name Jesus. I challenge anyone on the face of the earth to show me in the composition of translation from the original papyrus, the writings of the scrolls, whereby the name Jesus is even pronounced. It cannot be found. It's not there. And yet there are those that will get offended because of the way I say that. I frankly do not give a damn. We're dealing in an hour of great delusion. That's why we're not healthy here, and our bodies are not healthy. Because in order for anyone to succumb any challenge, it must be done here. You must develop this. And the reason that we do not have the power to overcome the insidious workers of darkness, because we don't have this here. We can trick ourselves all we want to. The name cannot be found here. Zakim bin Amin was praying, damn Christmas. I brought this for a purpose, all right? I see here in the writing, it says, Lefan's proper holy days. This is the original writing, the syntax of the King James. It is the same wording, same type of fonts. Nothing has changed. That's why it is called a facsimile. It simulates the original factual writing of the 1611. This is the original 1611 translation of the scrolls of our forefathers. In the name of Yeshua HaMashiach. And that is what amazed me about these deceitful liars. They call themselves Hebrew Israelites. Yet they take upon the pronouncing of a damn Greek, Latin, deceived God. The Japanese do not do that. They call upon Confucius. The Chinese, the Zen Buddhists, you will never find that superficial lie. And so you have many that are given over unto a delusion. We must prove all things. I want to teach from a different angle tonight because I had two Chochim to call me from Florida the other day. And they had questions, they had found the website. And of course, they were excited. They may be listening tonight. And so they say, Ra'ah, I have questions, please. Well, the only way I answer questions are from here. I do not voice my opinion. We must prove it. It must be tried in our bosom from here. And then we must prove it. So I notice here, I've always known this because I've had this book for many, many years. I've studied it, and I do all the time. That all of his, what we call holy, damn everything that is holy. You know, people don't understand grammatics and language because how can one express to you the dynamics When I use the word dynamics, it is simply the elements that produce in the sentence or the phrase that produce a visual conception of that in your mind. That you can literally see it, you can feel it. You understand the very interworkings of that. Just like someone trying to explain to you how to program a computer or a certain language. Unless they began with the small of the elements of that, you will never understand. You cannot jump to some of the most dynamic processes. You cannot learn physics unless you understand the simplest of the mathematical formulas. So how do we elevate ourselves overnight to a pinnacle of great knowledge and understanding, yet we have not learned the first precepts of Yah? How does it come? It's an arrogance. It's a very hubris, a sinful, wicked pride. That's what it is. So I notice my friend Lofton, he has all of these days identified, excluding the Mo'adim, the feast days of Yah. He has St. Andrew, St. Thomas, the apostle, even the wording in this book, the spelling, it is totally outside of the parameter of words that we understand today. He has Christmas Day. He proceeds on with Ash Wednesday, the purification of Virgin Mary. He has Matthias, the Annunciation of the Lady Wednesday, and of course, he doesn't say Easter because there is no S, it's Ifle. All of this contained in this book. That's why we must have men that are masters of certain identities of Torah. Everyone wants to master everything. And it doesn't work. It doesn't work. That's a fact. The old cliche of the proverbia, I'm a jack of all trades, but I master none of them. I can do a little plumbing, I can do electrical work, I can do carpentry, I can do a little brick masonry work, but I'm not the master of any of them. In order for you to become a master of any kind of labor or any kind of trade or any type of professional course, it takes time and years and working and laboring. It takes that. And so overnight you find those that are masters of Torah. And they know everything about Torah. You found those even today that they incorporated themselves within the activities of something that is so vile, so wicked, and so unclean. It is a vile order to the nostrils of Yah. I will never eat their meals. I will never be a part of any. I learned this when I was 23, 24-year-old young lad. And because of that, I lost mother, my only sister, brothers as well. You understand? Now, you may have known it, but you didn't lose brothers and sisters and mamas and daddies. And that's a fact. Because I took a stand for what was right, and I take a stand today. Why is this delusion of our minds captivate us? What is a delusion? If I ask the general populace, the public, can you define the words delusion, illusion, deceit? They all got an answer. But that doesn't mean that there is the proper identity to that word as it is defined, as the concept was developed in the mind of the linguist, to give us the linguistics, the speech, and the definitive of that word, that we may know how to use it in the proper syntax, in the proper grammatic form, in the right place, the verb in its right position, the adjective, the superlative to now the subject. Oh, I know this may not mean much, but it is the truth. I'm laying this down because I want to take us somewhere. So how does one understand when they don't even understand language? And if I ask any of us, what does the word delusion mean? We will have a plethora of differences of definitive, of definition. Yet there is only one. You understand, not many. Well, I don't mean that. That's what I meant. No, you meant what you said, man. This is an arrogant generation. No one wants to be wrong. No one wants to condescend and say, I'm wrong. I don't know, man. Teach me. I must say, my friend, I'm glad that I've never had that kind of arrogance. Never been that haughty. Never. I always say, teach me, show me. Show me. Teach me. You understand. I've never been ashamed to say, I am ignorant. Still am. I'm an ignorance man. Oh, no, my friend, you're not ignorant. Sure I am. So are you. I'm not offended at that. I don't want to know everything. I want to know the right thing for the right time. When to shut my mouth, when to walk orderly, when to act, and when to react. I want to operate in that realm. Because in this hour that we're in, when one can buy a myth, a lie that is so grotesque, when one can buy the lie of Christmas and Jesus Christ. I saw a little clip the other day. The woman's name is Megan Kelly. She is one of the renowned scholars of Fox News. She said to all that were listening, quote, I want to tell you something. There is this African-American woman, she has written a blog on Santa Claus, this demon, this hog of a lie, this vile demon of hell. And she says that Santa should not be white. Well, I'm sorry, Santa is white. She became very belligerent. I said, you're right, Megan Kelly. You're absolutely right. She says, and by the way, I want you to know that Jesus Christ is white as well. And you could see the anger in this woman's face. No, it's not what I said. It's what she said. I wasn't offended. I said, I'm glad you got it right. When I was in school, we learned the concept of a little white lie. It's all right to tell that. We can be hypocrites all we want to. When I was a young lad, you could get by with a little white lie. And so there was this tumultuous roar with people. They were offended. I wasn't offended. Why? She told the truth. Santa is white, with rosy cheeks and all of that. Jesus Christ is white. You can paint him with dreadlocks all you want to. He is still just who he is. You can alter him and put 7 locks on him. It doesn't mean a damn thing. He is just who he is. And that's the truth. And we don't want to buy truth. We rather live under this illusion of deception. That's this nation. It loves deception. So this, quote, African-American woman, unquote, was somewhat perturbed because of her childhood seeing the tremendous agony of racism. She wanted to make Santa Claus a penguin. And so all of her guests were offended at that. And she said, all you little children that are listening, and all of you that are listening to me, it's just not the truth. And of course, when her heels were set on fire, she come back with a rebuttal. Well, I said that tongue in cheek. This Jezebel, you're a coward. You can't own up to what you say. I own up to anything I say. If you said I said it, I said it. Just like that. You see how unhealthy the mind of this nation is? There are these fools that spent their last dime. But I give y'all a great hand. Because he is in control and in charge of all things. He is the one that ordained the concept in their mind. He is the one that gave them their Xmas, their Christmas. He is the one that gave them their holy, damnable like ghosts. He gave them all of that. Because it's full of deceit. I'm a student. Damn the Holy Ghost. How about that? Damn any ghost. Because when I was young, a ghost, you did not represent anything that were fruitful. You see how simple the minds of this twisted, damned generation is? There is not one delusion that doesn't come from Yah. Unless I can prove that in the Brit Hadassah, we call the new or the renewed covenant, and the old covenant, and what is written in this book, it's a lie, but it is the truth. I want to teach you something here tonight. It's not going to take me long. How about that? First of all, I want to define the word delusion. I want to define that. But this is what delusion, it implies. I have one of the, probably the best world college dictionary that one can purchase. It costs me $2 a month to use it. It's worth $12 a year for me. There are certain things that I take pleasures in, and I like to be able to understand the concept and the meaning of words. Not what I have conceived in my own environment to create a definitive, but what the original word defines, all right? Then I will express to you that same word in the language of our forefathers, in the Hebraic, the Aramaic. This is the word delusion. In our vernacular, in our speech, it is a noun. And this is what it implies. It is a fix. You'll hear that, fix. It is established, it is settled. It is a fixed, false belief. That is the resistance to reasoning or confrontation to that which is factual. Now, that's what delusional is. It is a fixed belief in one's heart. And although they see the truth, they will not buy it. Although they can look at the truth, they will not deal with the factual and the confrontation of their delusion. It is an illusion. And then maybe you all can help me with this word. I want to make sure I have it right. It is spelled G-H-O-S-T. G-H-O-S-T, that spells what? Ghost? Holy Ghost, huh? It is a ghost. It is a belief that is so intense and so ingrained. It is a belief hell. It is something that we hold on to. It is a belief hell. We hold it in great adoration, great inspiration. It is a belief hell in the face, in the face, in the face of evidence to the contrary. Regardless, I'm going to hold on to it. It is a belief, it is a belief and attitude that is hell, regardless of the factual, the truth. You call? You all call? Anybody call? You call? A little bit. All right, turn that down for me. It is a concept that is held within one's own mind, irregardless of the fact that is contrary to their belief. They are adamant, and they still hold fast to it. That concept that is resistance, it resists to all reasons of truth of that matter. It makes no difference. Now, how many of you all would have given that composition of delusion? Not one of us. Truth. None of us. We know everything, don't we? I'm glad I don't. It's a fact. So regardless, we hold fast to those things. Well, your mama celebrated Christmas. I don't give a damn. She can do what she wants to. I will not be a part of her activities. Not me. She can, but not me. And I wasn't. So I was cast out. That's all right. I don't mind being cast out. Hallelujah. So despite the empirical evidence, one holds fast to that which is a delusion. I want to read why delusions come. Can I show us that? That's why there are those that say they're Hebrews, but they will hold on to tenets, this most deceitful, damnable lie. They will say, y'all told me to go sit down with my mother and have a Christmas dinner, and I talked about Yah with them. I didn't bring no gifts. You're Jezebel. You are an effeminate young boy. You're not a man. And that's a fact. I must prove this. If I began in the renewed covenant, I must prove this in the book. Must come from the mouths of the prophets. It must. Now, we don't do that, but you all expect me to do it, don't you? You all don't do it. You all read. I'm a student. I'll tell you what these verses are so you can write them down. You won't have to be troubled tonight, my Zachin. David's out there in Los Angeles. Greet you all. Brother Chris, that are gathered with our Ach there in Los Angeles. I would have begun here in 2 Thessalonica, 2 Thessalonians. I would have begun here in verse 2, why delusion and how it enters in. I want us to understand this. It says in 2 Thessalonica, Thessalonians, chapter 2 and verse 10. This is a process that Shaul speaks as to what shall be. This anti-Havashiach spirit, it is not Ruach. It is not the living power of the mind of Yah. But this anti-fervor, Yahshua shall enter in. Will oppose everything that is righteous. The mind will succumb to everything that is delusional and wicked. They will give great credence unto that. So he speaks unto the house. Here in 2 Thessalonica, Thessalonians chapter 2, verse 10. He said, the one that shall rise up. And our minds, this Nahash, always rise up, doesn't it? And it is one of the most deceitful things upon the face of the earth. Nothing else. It is the love of man that is deceitful above all things, and it is desperately wicked. He said, this one, this spirit, shall rise up with all mirma, deceit, deceivableness. The same nature of Hashatan, with great guile, to beguile, with feigned words to seduce, to draw into this delusion. It will be very subtle, and the results of that is a treacherous, wicked mind. A liar hates everyone that is affected by it. And the lies of Jesus doesn't give a damn. And Christmas, and the damn hog day of butchering the Indians. The independence, not of those of the diaspora, not of those that were under the bondage of change and slavery, but the celebration of this nation free from the British control. That's what that's about. He said, this one shall come and our minds present itself to Yah. He says, with all kind of evil, unrighteousness. It is a mindset that is vicious. It fights against truth. It operates in the violent deeds of injustice. Gives no justification to the Most High. It doesn't honor Yah. He says, in them that perish, why? Everyone is going to perish. I don't care if they're 99 or 109. He said, everyone. He talks about the coal, the full, the whole, the substance. He says, and all that perish. In them that perish, why? Because this is the reason they perish. Because they receive not the love of the Torah. They did not receive the love of Torah. They don't love Torah. They don't love the wisdom of Yah. And all them that perish, because they receive not the love of the Torah, they will hold fast to their Christmas and their Jesus and their Jesus and the lies that have been purported. Because they receive not the love of the truth. Now, I know that we will hear men say all the time, well, the truth is his word, but that's not what Torah says. I must define what truth is, first of all. You find that in Tehillim, Psalms 119 and verse 142. Tehillim, Psalms. This is only truth, what I'm about to read. He says unto Yah, David says, he says, your sadacha, it is your character. It is your characteristics. It is your mind. For your sadacha, he says, it is an everlasting righteousness, or the righteousness of Yah. It is olam v'ed. It lasts forever. It is an everlasting righteousness. And he says, and your law, your Torah, it is the truth. Now that's what truth is. I know Torah is composed of words, but we must go to the Torah to find his imat. That's the only way you're going to find truth. And so when I speak tonight, if I don't find this in the utterance of the mouths of the prophets, then it's a lie. It's a lie. He said, that is what truth is. Your Torah. Your Torah is truth. Your Torah is truth. That is the truth, YisraYah. Not what Lofen says here in this book, that they instigated and integrated the deceit of their own lies. And that's just the truth. And we must have men that are just brazen and bold and will not even concern themselves about the simple childlike emotion of this silly, unhealthy generation. They cannot, YisraYah. That's a fact. So first of all, we establish, Sha'u said, because they receive not the love of the truth. We establish what truth is. His Torah is truth. In Tehillim, I'm sorry, in Thessalonica, the next verse, verse 11. Because we don't love truth, because we don't have aspiration and inspiration by truth, Shaul says, I want to tell you something. Because of that, he says, and for this reason, for this call, 2 Thessalonica, Thessalonians chapter 2, verse 11. He said, for this cause, he did not say Hashatan. He says, oh, my Yahshua sin, strong Mahasallah. Nahasallah. He shall send strong delusion. He's going to send deceptions and illusions. And the ghost too. He sent the Holy Ghost. He sent the Holy Ghost. He shall send strong delusions. For what, Yah? That they all should believe a shekhah, a deception that is so powerful that you will denounce truth for a lie. You will denounce Yeshua's name for damn Jesus and the damn filthy Holy Ghost. The Baptist got it. The Methodist got it. Your crazy, wicked grandmammy got it, and she is wicked as they come. You got it, and you're still wicked. You might as well love me. If the righteous scarcely make it, and we all think we're righteous, don't we? We're going to scarcely make it. By the skin of our nephesh, you're not going in any kind of way. For this cause, he says, Yah says, because they did not receive the love of the truth, he's going to send strong delusion that they should believe a lie. Jesus is a damn lie. Christmas is a damn lie. Thanksgiving is a damn lie. The Holy Ghost is a damn lie. That they should believe a lie. Why? That they all, that's inclusive, conclusive, that they all might be damned. Do y'all hear that? That they all might be damned that believe not the truth. For your Torah is, it used that same word, ha, is the truth. That they all might be damned. And anyone that doesn't believe the truth and walk in truth, they're going to be damned. I don't care who it is. Yah has sent the delusion to make them stand fast on lies and hold fast to lies and denounce Yah, that they all might be damned. Now, unless there is precedent to this, what Shaul says, then it's a lie. Unless Yah has sent delusions upon his nation, his people, and upon those, then this is a lie. We don't search the book to understand his mind. We search the book and we read the book to present our mind, which is childish, stupid, immature. It is not even sufficient of significance of what you know to even strengthen you. That's where we fall constantly into the gates of our own sinful activities. He's going to send strong delusion. Because they did not believe the truth, but they had pleasures in evil and unrighteousness. The folks had pleasures today, didn't they? They ate their hog meat and chitlin pies and lobsters and shrimps and crab cakes and all. They defy and defile even the very Torah of health. That's why we're in the damn shape we're in. We're young, we can't even walk a block. We love the God of our belly. Let's get real. We all love that God. And we don't want to chasten ourselves that way because of our pride and our delusion. We don't want to talk to me that way. Why? I want to make it into the kingdom. I'm not here to play. I'm not here pretending. I'm not here because I have no members. I'm here because I want truth. When every man to stand before me, I said to my Israel, I said, I don't care what one preach, it's me. Even if they talk about adultery being unfaithful to you, I've been unfaithful to him. I'm convinced by every word that I'm a man that's in need. We are very self-aggrandizing people. That's not for me. You're a fool. He sends his word to me, and it heals me every time. It heals me every time. It heals me. He sent forth his word, and it rapha, it healed them. It heals me every time. I'm guilty of everything that he calls the messenger to say. I've done it. I've done it. We tend to get upset, don't we? We get angry. What a mindset. What a heart that is far from Yah. That's the truth. I want to proceed a little further here, all right? The delusions. The Mahach Allah. It is so strong that you defy Yah. You denounce his Hamashiach. You call him a Christ, one that is anointed. His Hamashiach has been anointed by him. And that's just the fact. So the messenger, Yeshua, Isaiah, he speaks to us of the great Mishpatim, the judgments of Yah. And the reason that we procure that upon us, Yisrael, you know why? Because we are a nation that have contempt for what Yah says. We despise it. We despise his correction. We despise what he says. So the messenger Isaiah speaks here in Isaiah chapter 30. Isaiah, Yeshayah, chapter 30, verse 8. Hallelujah. Yah commands him by his wisdom. He says, now go right. He uses the words hatta to inscribe indelibly, to make sure that as an icon, make sure that it is engraved upon the tablet, upon the stone. He said, write before them at a table and note it in a book that it may be for the time to come. Are we in the time to come? He told this messenger to write it. You write this saying. It's not for you today, but it's for the time to come. The time that would enter in. The time that would bore. The time, the yom that would come. He says, and did he use the word forever and ever? Olam. It is eternal. It doesn't stop. He said, listen now, I want you to understand this in verse 9. He said that this is a rebellion, a meri. When Yah used the word meri, he's saying that we're rebellious. I'm rebellious. But he says, Ra'ah is meri. He says, not just rebellious. He is double the attitude of rebelliousness. His neck is so stiff with defiance. We never done that, have we? We've never been defiant, I know. We've never stiffened our neck, have we? He says, so Mary, so defiant, so stubborn, such a rebellious one. He is so rebellious that he is bitter. We've never gotten bitter when we've been corrected, have we? Okay then, just you and me then, huh? All right, everyone else. He says, this is the rebellious people. Their children are full of shekha, they're lying children. And he says this is why we lie. He said, because they're children that will not hear the Torah of Yah. We won't hear the Torah, will we? He said, these are people that will not hear the Torah, for his Torah is his truth. You don't want to hear Torah, you don't want truth. If you don't want Torah, you don't want truth. You want those fictitious lies, the fairy tale, like the Baptist devil gets up there and tell you. Church of God in Christ, effeminate liar, and the megathon whorehouse is what they teach you. And these false delusional suspect Hebrews, they say to the seers, see not. And to the prophet, this is what they say, prophesy not to us with straightforwardness. Who wants the truth today? Don't tell me the truth about me. That's how we are. Don't prophesy with straightforwardness. Shall I? To them. They get up before the people, those that call themselves Hebrews as well. Yea, thus saith the Lord thy God, you shall have riches. Nah, tell the truth. For your sins have come up before the Nazareth of Yah. There is a requirement. He demands and he commands. They say, speak to us smooth things. Prophesy unto us Mary. Prophesy unto us deceit. Mary now. Tell us things to make us stubborn. Tell us things to make us hard and rebellious and stiff-necked. Don't tell me it's wrong not to keep Christmas. Damn Christmas. Well, that's the name. Well, what about those that were saved in his name? And they say, well, I ask you, what about those that were not saved in that name? In 1611, are they saved? Yah saved this house, Yisrael. Not this damnable, twisted concept of what we think salvation is. He saved his people out of the land of Mizraim. He's going to save them out of the spiritual land of Mizraim. He saved his people. Show me one place where he did not, Yahshua, deliver them out of the hand of Bavel, out of the Amorites, Hittites, out of the great battle. Show me where he did not deliver his people. He has given us a sure sign in Yahshua, a great comforter, by that revelation that grows and blossoms in our bosom as long as we abide in Torah. So tell us lies and give us lies. Yah says, I've sent the lips of the lying prophets. I've caused them to lie to us because we like lies. Well, I don't see anything wrong with that. It's all wrong, Yisrael. You give no strength to Christmas or any of the damn pagan days. None of them. None of them. There's sun worship or any. You remember Hashabbat. You set it apart. You don't go to the damn funerals on the Shabbat. Nothing. Let the dead bury the dead. You keep what is righteous and true. His Torah is the truth. These are the mitzvah of Yah. He tells us the Zakah HaShabbat. Shema, keep it set apart. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Are we deserving of that? We say to Yah, prophesy unto us, unto our messengers. Well, don't tell me that. Tell me things. Tell me that I'm nice. Prophesy lies unto us that we understand why. We don't understand why we are deserving of the judgment. Well, I want to speak from even Shlomo's mouth out of the book of wisdom. Hear this. Wisdom. Chapter 17, verse 1. He tells Yah, he says, great or gadol, great. This is what he says to Yah now. He says, great almighty Yah are your judgments. Your mishpatim, your wisdom to correct. Your wisdom to bring us into the way perfect. He says, listen to this now. He says, great, gadol, are your judgment. He said, and your judgments are so beautiful and so right, they're hard to describe. Who can describe the judgments of Yah? We think we're wise, don't we? He said, they're so hard to describe. Therefore, he says, therefore, because they're so difficult to comprehend, to understand, he said, therefore, the uninstructed nefesh, that individual that has not been instructed, they go astray. Because your judgment is so difficult to learn for the unintelligent man, for the unintelligent woman, they can't learn the ways of Yah. He said, for when this is a tenet of your environment, when the Torah lustness, when men without the wisdom of Torah, when men without the constitution of the power of Torah, when the Torah less men, listen, suppose that they hail the Kodash or the nation of Yisra'iyah in their power. Men that say we're Hebrews and I got you all in my power to teach you. When they supposed to have been wise men. He said they themselves lay as captive of the darkness of the Hoshek. Their minds are dark. They're lustful men. They prey on the silly women laden with sin and corruption. They draw to them. Yes. Heard this Jezebel the day say that, well, yon thing for man, he can have seven wives. I'm like, Hefe, where is that in the Torah? That's the word that's in the Torah. These are some lying dogs today. These broke back clowns can't even take care of one wife. What in the hell are they going to do taking care of seven? And women are so silly and immature, they buy that. Yah has one wife. One. That's Yisra'iyah. One. That's why when a man finds a wife, he finds an excellent thing. Every woman is not a wife. He has no need for spoils. When he has a chayilah, woman that is virtuous and strong. Her beauty is exemplified by her personality and her attitude. I work on everything, don't I? I know that's right. Get quiet. I got herbs, I can't. He said, they themselves lay as captives of the darkness and prisoners of long night, shut in under their roof, exile from the eternal province. They have no concept of the eternal power of Yah. They're shut up in their little world. This is my world. I got my own opinion. You hear people say that, don't you? Well, they're telling you they got their judgment. True judgment comes from Torah. Well, everybody entitled to their own opinion. Your opinion doesn't mean a damn thing. It's worthless. Your judgment means nothing. It is corrupt, it's false, it is not true. He says, for thinking that in their secret sin, they were unobserved behind a dark curtain of forgetfulness. We think that. We think of the secret playground of our minds that Yah doesn't see our wickedness. You're not hiding. He said, because of that, they were scattered. That's why Yisra'iyah was scattered. Puts, and that's why we scattered from one another. They were scattered. Terribly alarmed and appalled by the scepter. They don't want the scepter of Yah. We don't want that strength of correction. He goes on to say, for not even in the inner chambers that held them, protect them from fear. But terrifying sounds ring out around them, and a dismal phantom with gloomy face appeared. That's your Holy Ghost. That's what a ghost is. It's a phantom, isn't it? That's what the Holy Ghost is. There are folks, when I say that, they cringe. Oh, he said, damn the Holy Ghost, it's a lie. It is made up from the Sanskrit language. One of the 17 major languages of India that deals with one aspect of the Indian life. I know what I'm saying. It deals with Hinduism. And so when those translators found no words within the vernacular of the English language, they would draw from every religious concept there was. And they had a plethora of religious words to draw from the Sanskrit language. Every word in the Sanskrit language, it has seven words to everything. Ghosts, there are seven types of ghosts in their descriptive nature. And they all have a specific character and characteristics. So that every word, there are seven ways to say the word river. Like Yam in our forefathers' language, the Yam, the river. Well, they got seven words to say river. You tell me, I see why they got 300 million gods.
Damn all of their gods.
Damn the God that's spelled with the big G and the God that's spelled with the little G. How about that? Every God is a dog. It's a concept of the mind that man has made up. You historians, find the word God for me. Show me your etymology. Show me where that concept was ever developed. There's no history to it. Fact. Hallelujah. He says that no power of fire was able to give light. None. Nor did the brilliant flames of the stars avail to illumine the hateful night. Listen to this now. Nothing was shining through to them except a dreadful self-kindled fire. And in terror they deemed the thing which they saw to be worse than the unseen appearance. As the old folks would say, it's coming. You may not see it, but it's coming. This is what the wisdom of Shalom tells us. He says in Wisdom 17:7, he says that the delusions of their secretive or their magic, he says, are laid humble, and their boasted wisdom was scornfully rebuked. For those who promise, these are the ones that stand before us and promise to drive off the yira, the fear that we have, the drive off fear and disorder of the sick nephesh. We're going to cast a demon out of you, you damn dog. You are the demon. And they come every time. I got a demon. Stop. That filthy mess. It's vile. These are the ones that we're going to lay hands, get the demon out. People are stupid. They don't like me. It's amazing because I remember we started this website. I would check it every day. Got 6 visitors. Wow. 2. Ooh. I prayed. I said, yeah, if we get up to 1,000 people a year, that would be wonderful. We're nearly approaching 300,000 people from every part of the world. They come. From every country. It's going to witness for them or against them. I'll read that again because I don't have much time. He said, for those who promise to drive off the fear, you got troubles and all of that. I said to one day, I said, now, if Benny Hinn and T.D. Jakes are casting out demons by the same name you are using, you say they're false, then what are you? The person replied, well, I haven't thought about that. I know you haven't, because you haven't run up against one like me. Damn Benny Hinn, T.D. Jakes, and all of them. Now, those that promise you now to drive off the fear and disorder of your sickness. We're going to cast out the demon. We're going to make sure your nephesh is all right. He said they were sick themselves. They're sick. You are sick, man. You're a sick woman. They were sick themselves with ridiculous fear. I don't have to worry about no demon. The greatest battle to YisraYah, well, even that in Torah, Yah says the nations you should know your great people, not because you cast out a demon, but because you have a Torah that is so superb to all nations. That's why. And we live such lives that are so rightful and righteous according to Torah. You understand? And so Yahshua, even in the demonstrations of the Shadim, it was shown every man. Come on, it's here in our own hearts. You understand? I remember that bull crap as a young ignorant lad. They wouldn't lay hands on me because it was amazing. All these preachers, when they would come, I would go. It was something, they would just stand back and look at me. They would. Because I would, you're not just going to lay hands on me. No, you're not going to lay hands on me. I look at them. Yea, the Lord says, you got your mighty mind. Go to hell. Oh, they will say that to me. Stand up back there, brother.
quote, the Lord got his hands on you.
I'm glad he didn't. I'm glad the Lord didn't have his hands on me. I'm glad y'all had his hands. You silly little boy. Let me read this quickly. I'm going to finish on time. So Yah says in Thessalonica, yeah, he's going to send strong delusions. Unless I can show you, according to the witness of the prophets, what I've said tonight means nothing. Isaiah chapter 66. Hallelujah. Isaiah 66. Yah is the one that chooses the delusion, Yisrael. Verse 1 quickly. This says Yah. Yah says that the Shemayim are my kese. This is where my throne is. And the earth is my footstool. Where is the bed that you build for me? And where is the place of my rest? He says, for all those things have my hands made. And all those things that have been, says Yah. But to this man will I look, even to him that is, and to those that are a knee, and of a contrite ruah, and those that tremble at my debah, that tremble at my word. Now we don't tremble at the word of Yah, do we? Let's get real, we don't tremble. It doesn't cause our hearts to fear. He says, he that kills an ox as he slew a man, he that offers a lamb as if he cut off a dog's neck, he that offer an oblation as he offers swine blood. Now this is what we're doing. The things that are unclean, we're not lifting up clean hands and hands that are kadosh. He that burned incense as if he blessed an idol, an ovin, something that is so abominable and filthy, something that is so vile and full of iniquity. Yah says this, for they have chosen their own ways. We don't choose our own ways, do we? Let's get real. This book speaks to us. For they have chosen their own way. I don't have to do that. I don't have to lift my hands. I don't have to praise him. I don't have to offer an oblation. I'm thinking about my fat back sandwich. You see that? For they have chosen their own ways. And their nephesh delights in their shikhuts. Not to a babo shikhuts. In their own abomination. In their own vile, deplorable, wicked nature. We delight in ourselves, don't we? We choose our own ways. We'll write about every damn thing. Everybody's wrong, but we're right. Yosef, you've chosen your own ways. We haven't chosen the derech, the way of Yah. We have not walked in Torah. We've chosen our own ways. Yah says that. Yah says, because you have done that, because you have chosen your own ways, he said, I got something for you, buddy. How about that? Yah says, you choose your ways. Yah says in Yeshaya 66:4, I will also choose their. Does he say that? We can play all we want to. We can pretend. Yah says, I will also choose. You have chosen to walk in your own ways. You have chosen in your shikhuts, your vile ways, that you know what Torah says. You know this Zaken Torah on Shabbat, he says that in order for you to get it right or the forgiveness, you must bring the right offering. And if we have anything in our heart against Yisrael, Yah commands us to lay our gifts down at the altar. Your prayers doesn't mean a damn thing. And get it right. But you have chosen your own ways. Yah said, I'm going to choose the delusion for your wicked, vile nature.
I'm going to send you a delusion. You're going to think you're right. You're going to defy everything. We don't think like that. And the reason why, because we don't develop our minds to be healthy. We love trash and every damn thing that is vile. The way we eat naturally is the way we eat spiritually. We can't get enough of folly and foolish conversation that produce nothing at all. That's why we choose that path to fill ourselves with all kinds of things. We eat naturally the same way we eat spiritually. Fact. I don't care if you don't love me. I shall man. But our mind's unhealthy, our body's unhealthy. Our thoughts unhealthy. We talk on our minds. Now we want someone to say, don't worry, my friend. Now I'm not going to speak smooth things. You have chosen your own ways. Yah says, I got something for you. Since you think you're mightier than me, I would choose the delusion. That's why he's going to send strong delusion. And Yah uses the word strong, nothing defies it. He's going to send strong delusions. Hell, that we believe the Lord Jesus Christ and defend it. I defend Yahshua HaMashiach. I defend my Abba. I'm set for defense of Torah. I'm nothing to defend because there's not anything in me that is of any value. It's just the truth. I'm not worth a damn thing. You have chosen your own ways, and we are students of choosing our own ways. We're students. Nobody tell us nothing. Nobody. It's almost like a mother raised 10 youngins. Little girl, 19, 23, 24, 25, got a youngin. Well, Mama, I know what I'm doing. I've raised 10. Well, Mama, I know you raised me, but I know what I'm doing. That's the arrogance of this generation. This is the stupidity. Grandma, you got to get with it. You little dirty heifer. You don't even know how to bathe. You stinking little cow. You stupid boy. Well, granddaddy, you don't know. I'm young. You jackass. I'm going to close here. Let me read this again. All right. How about? Yah says, because you have chosen, they have chosen their own ways. Yeshayah 66:3 in the latter part. He says, and their nephesh, their being, their conscience, their mind. He uses the word delights, we have it. We take pleasure. It is our will to do it. Not my will, but thine hafetz be done your will. So when Yah says that they delight, they got a will to do it. We got a will to be defiant and to choose our own way. Well, I don't care what you say. Just almost like someone showing you how to do something. I got it. I'll do it this way. Show me how to do it, man. Okay. All right. As I said, there's more than one way to skin a cat. Okay, then, wow. Well, maybe I can enhance. I was messing up doing it that way. Let me do it. I've never been arrogant like that. So, okay, all right, show me. Man, I like that. Make my job easy. Show me a way to cut them trees over there where that big Johnson ran. Hurt your back and all that. You get that big bad boy going. Ain't nothing to play with. I like the way she cut this. Cut that wood. I like cutting that wood. She's ready to chomp, isn't she? That's all right, girl. We going to the dance floor. I cut all day. Yah says, because of that, I will also choose their delusions. And I will bring their fear up. He's going to bring your own fear upon you. Why? Because he's calling us tonight. What I call... None did answer. Do we answer the call of truth?
Do we answer the call when He judges us and show us our hearts to say, it's me, Yah, not mama, dad, but it's me. He said, when I spoke, they did not even shemach. They didn't even hear me. They didn't hear me with the desire to obey. But they did evil before my eyes and chose that which I delight not. I don't delight in your ways. He doesn't delight in our ways. We better get real, get healthy, and get fat now. We better get fat. You understand? Fat. He delights not in any of our ways, none of them. He's going to send the delusion. That's why He sent the delusion of Jesus Christ, to give them a lie. He's going to damn them all. All the Jesus thumpers, He's going to damn them. I'm telling you. When they turn their back away from truth, woe unto them. May the riches of Yah rest upon your shoes name. Come on, Zacchaeus, He's going to come. Dismiss us. May He enrich you all. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Shalom kol to all Yisrael. Just as we heard tonight, Yisrael, we cannot be led by our own concepts, our own precepts. What I believe, what I have been taught, only by Torah shall we find the way, and the only way, Yahweh's way, to everlasting life and contentment. Reassurance in Torah. That is the only way, Yisrael. Because our way only leads us to death and destruction and separation. Don't we see that throughout the world? All the time. Death, destruction, separation. But yet, walking in the light of Almighty Yahweh, His way brings life everlasting. Hallelujah. So we do give Torah unto Yah for that. But let's stand to our feet, Yisrael. Hallelujah. We're getting quite chilly tonight. Matter of fact, the next quite a few days, it's going to get even colder, Yisrael. Hallelujah. But let us allow the warmth of the truth of Almighty Yahweh to warm our lives, Yisrael. Let us not be cold. Let us be affectionate one to another, ahava one another, and do all we can for one another, Yisrael. Hallelujah. Abba Yahweh, we do told you for this night, this Wednesday night scripture of Torah truth. We do ask, Abba Yahweh, as those that travel home, Abba Yahweh, even this time of year, we know that the fools are out there doing their own thing, Abba Yahweh. But yet, Yahweh, we know that you send your Malat, your Melekim, to a camp around Yisrael. So bring our Zakein, those that have traveled home safely, Abba Yahweh, and give them, Abba Yahweh, strength even to overcome even this spiritual warfare, Abba Yahweh. We give you Todah, we barak you for Yahshua, HaMashiach, we do declare tonight. Hallelujah. 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 Yabarak Kol Yisrael. Hallelujah.